Georgia had her first fender bender yesterday.
Oh no, bummer.
How did I get it done?
You know, she got her car like 6 weeks ago. So yeah, got to get it done. But she, we had told her before she got her car, you know, if you ever have an accident, no matter whose fault it is, if your car is drivable and you're not injured and everything's safe, pull over to a safe place like a parking lot or side of the road, somewhere safe out of traffic, put on your hazards and make sure you share your information, your driver's license and your insurance, and get that from the other driver. Take a picture of the car, of the license plate, of the insurance card, anything like that. So she calls me yesterday and goes, I had a fender bender. I was like, what happened? She was stopped at a red light, waiting to turn right. And someone pulled out of the 7-Eleven parking lot and hit her. She was stopped at the red light. So the 60-some-year-old white guy gets out of his car and starts screaming at her, screaming. And she's like, this was not my fault. I was stopped at a red light. You hit me. She did everything I'd asked to, put her hazards on and everything. This was in front of a 7-Eleven, which is next to a laundromat. It's right around the corner from my house. If those of you who live in my neighborhood probably know exactly where it is. It's like two blocks up. So this African-American guy comes running out of the laundromat and gets between Georgia and the white guy and says to the white guy, this is a 16-year-old kid. This is her first accident. You need to stop yelling at her. You need to back up and you need to have an appropriate distance from her and you need to treat her like she's 16 years old and stop acting like an asshole.
And Did the guy
He did. He stopped. He shut up. And Georgia was then able to say, here's my license and my insurance, and got his. And this fella just kind of intervened and then went back in the laundromat. And I went back and tried to find him and he was gone. So
bless his heart.
I was like, thank you. But Georgia was like, you see that kind of stuff on Criminal Minds. You know, he was backing me into my car. This white guy was just backing me up and I was about to have to sit down in my car. And I, the whole thing, time I was thinking, this is the way this happens on Criminal Minds. He's going to put me in my car. I was like, okay. Okay. Thank God for this guy who came to your rescue, because her brain had stopped functioning because she's watched too many episodes.
Oh, right.
To think she's getting abducted in this fender bender.
It's happening. It's happening. Oh my gosh.
Anyway, I thought it was funny that that's where her brain went. This was just like Criminal Minds. I was about to be abducted. But thank God for that guy. I don't know. I'm sure he does not listen to my podcast, but to the world, thank you for a kind citizen who was just minding his own business, watching what was going down, and
who was a helper
to help her, because I feel confident in the middle of the street, nothing would have happened to her bad, but it's terrifying to have your first fender bender that's not your fault and have some adult man yelling at you in the middle of the street. It's terrifying. Yeah.
It's so inappropriate.
Inappropriate. But she was fine. She wasn't very shaken up. She was very grateful for this fella who came.
Good girl.
So thank you, God, and whoever was watching over her and sent that little guy. Because I literally went back. I was like, I got a Starbucks gift card. I was going to go give him a gift card. Be like, thank you so much. And then he was gone. So I was really bummed. But yeah, it was really funny. Oh my God. It's like an episode of Criminal Minds.